some way by helping us in environmental characteristics to which endemic species are unique in that. Why are there endemic species in Kamerad? The vegetation is adapted to the different conditions. Why are there more organisms on flora than fauna? Fauna can walk, flora can do that. This is some of the different endemic species in Korea. The first one is the Antirrhinum cheridae. It lives in rocks and volcanic walls, and it can live in all the area of Camerata, especially in this part of Camerata. Cheiriopus marcellianus. It lives in thermophilic zones close to the sea. Can live in all the coasts of Camerata. Pneumonium estelae. It lives in margins of ravines, slopes, or sandy soils. It lives mostly in these places. This is one of the most important flowers of Camerata. It's called the Narcissus obsolescens. It's in the plant from the San Montana, which is in the National Park of Camerata. The Narcissus of plants, they have a various fruit that is used for anyone. They are located from here. This is another important one that links to the Narcissus region. It's also called Barbarina, and it's a special flowering plant that dwarf fires. Its vessels are blue, and it's a member of the Iridaceae family. It can be found in a method around that. Chenorium organophorium. It's an endemic plant of various woods, and it can be found in all these areas, especially in here. This one is called Chenorium sumicus. It grows naturally in the Sierra de Cabrera, where it's one of the most characteristic species. But it can also live in all the green area in the mountain. Where are there endemic species in Sierra Nevada? There are different climatic factors in Sierra Nevada than in every other place. The altitude difference and the location are. These are some endemic species in Sierra Nevada. Agriatic sumicus. It's a butterfly that lives in meadows at an altitude of up to 2,400 meters. It can live in all the area of Sierra Nevada. Pinguicula neovalensis. It lives in the Balagueros and in the most unique areas, such as Mohai Mountain Ridgelands. It can live up to 2,500 meters and is a carnivorous plant. Diagnosis of Philoides. This is a pink plant and it's very beautiful. It lives in the clearings of the Enebro and dry soil. It can live up to 2,000 meters. Phylomatous Globus. It's a butterfly that lives in areas of low density scrub. That's an altitude of 2,500 meters to 3,200 meters. This is some endemic species in Andorra. This is Androtium europaeum. It's pink with pink veins and it lives in semi arid and sandy meadows up to 200 meters. It can live in this part of the coast. Centaurus of the dog. So exclusive enemies of Cerrados Pilares. It's pink and it lives in Sierras with little vegetation. Up to 1,500 meters. And Cerrados Pilares is here. This is a recent discovery. And it's called Coletina calafori. It's an underground insect of Sierra Delgada and the karst in the soils. It's a primitive animal. And it functions as a monkey. It lives in the dark environment inside caves. And it lives in here.
Hello, my name is Paola, and I'm going to talk about the endangered species of this autonomous region. This is one endangered species in Cantabria called the Drago uruguayus. It occurs in Canis lupus, in La Rioja, Amiga faciata, in Navarra, Neoplocus pecnotenus, in Aragon, Astrocotamobius paliper, in Catalonia, a strange animal called Precotus mangrovoyari, in Castilla y León, Capra piranenca, in Castilla-La Mancha, Lutrinaeus, in Murcia, a beautiful fish called Asphodelus iberus, and in Valencia, it's Jaetus aluminus. This is one of the most important endangered species in Spain called Lis marinus. They live in the Iberian Peninsula, and the diet is 90% of rabbits. In altitude, they live in altitude of 400 to 900 meters, and sometimes in 1,600 meters. Another important endangered species is Iberus walterianus. It lives in sunny, rocky, and mountainous areas from subarid environments. It lives in this part of Andalusia. Chameleon. It's another endangered species. It's my favorite because it can change the color for many reasons, to camouflage, to restrict more or less solar radiation. And they live in the southeast of Spain. Lepus castoricoi, another endangered species. These are some characteristics of this animal. They live in mountain slopes covered with broom trees and mountain forests in an altitude of 1,000 to 1,900 meters. And the habitat is in this part of Spain, in Cantabria. Like turkey, Monachus monachus, it's a seal without ears that is central to the Mediterranean Sea. And finally, how can we protect endangered species? Someone knows how can we do that? No. Well, these are some measures to protect endangered species. Capturing animals for human entertainment can lead to extinction. Food, shelter, and space suitable for reproduction is essential. Reduce our carbon footprint, which causes climate change. Recycling is preserved in the environment and protect animals in danger of extinction. And the last, respecting and various of closure. And thanks for watching this presentation.